Greetings, fellow girls, guys, and gaming fans. This is Small Archangel. Welcome back to another episode of Obduction. And today it looks like we are going to be dealing with this maze here. And it kind of reminds me a bit of small handheld puzzles where you need to turn. We obviously need to turn these four discs that we have here so that they create a pathway that we can get through from the lowest level of the elevator here through presumably to that pathway over there leading into that structure there or underneath it or wherever it goes. But I'm guessing that's what we need to do. Or maybe we need to reach that villein device over that other side, the opposite side there. I'm not sure. As per usual, we're going to be feeling our way. Now, this pillar turns the maze. So I guess we'll turn it. Does it matter which way it's facing? I'm going to start out, I think. We'll go the same way because I think we can turn it in both directions using the button on either side of the pillar. We'll start out with it facing this way because then I believe if we're down here, it probably won't get us anywhere, but I believe from below then we'll actually have, there we go, pathway in front of our face. It won't go very far because, oh look, we can go all the way around here and then it's a dead end. So that is what we need to sort out from our viewpoint above. Is to take a look at that. Now, of course, what we can do is take photographs of our progress. And that I might have to do just so that I know which way I'm shifting stuff. So there we go. That's a photograph of it as it stands. So we can get around that corner there, but it looks like we need that one to move. Do we need this one to move, actually? Possibly. Oh, I've no idea. Basically, I think each of these discs has underneath it a teleporter. So obviously, if we go down there now, we can go through there. But I believe right on the bottom level, there are three levels to this lift. There's this one where we had the overview. There's this one here, which is the maze itself. And then there is the bottom level here where we have a teleporter, and there is a teleportation chamber underneath every single one of these discs. And if we take this teleporter, it will take us back to the cave in Hunrath. That is not what I meant to do. What I meant to do was this. Photos. It will take us to the cave in Hunrath. There. This one. There we go. Where we'll be able to see. We're here. Which one? We'll be able to see this section of the maze, and we'll be able to turn it round. I think there's some buttons that we can do that. And if we turned that around, it would join up with that, but then it wouldn't necessarily. I don't know. I really don't know, because obviously we're not going to be able to get. We've got to start somewhere. We've got to start somewhere, and mostly trial and error has succeeded in this game, where actually knowing what the heck I'm doing has not. So let's give it a whirl. And you're back in the room. Okay, so here we are in Hunrath. Here is the teleporter. Okay. Find my way up here. We've already opened all the doors that are in here. There's kind of doors in both directions. We've opened those shortcuts already, so that's fine. Okay, so as we looked at the photo, and I'm going to have to look at the picture again here just to get this straight in my mind, it was going in that direction. So where I'm standing at the moment is effectively here. So I think what we need to do is turn it clockwise so that that elbow is facing like that, and it can connect these two. That is my guess. I could be wrong, but it's my guess. I think those two need to join up there, and I think maybe that needs to join those two there. This is my guess. So we need to get that around there. So that does mean turning it. We can turn it either way. Let's turn it anti-clockwise. Now, which one does that? I don't honestly know. Okay, that turns clockwise. That's fine. We'll turn it clockwise. And we'll turn it once more. So that is now facing kind of the opposite direction to the way that it was. And I'm assuming that that's going to be right. We'll just take a little looky at that again. I've just turned it around this way twice. So, yeah, I think that should do it. I think that should do it. This is a bit of experimentation and visualization. Let's go and... Oh, I can't get down the bloomin' steps. Safety stairs. You cannot fall off them. Probably just as well. It's kind of dark in here and I have no torch. Okay. Back to Marae and let's see if that worked. Okay. Oh, there we are. Couldn't find my way out there for a minute. Okay, so back up we go to our viewpoint. No, all the way to the top, please. There we go. No, that's not quite what I meant. I actually think we need that to go one more, don't we? Because we're never going to be able to join these two up. So actually, yeah, I think we need to go around one more with that. Is that going to do it? Or is it going to have to be more than that? Maybe actually, as we look at it from the button, maybe that is correct. Maybe what we're seeing is correct. Okay. Well, I think that needs turning one more. but I will try and observe. No, that's not what we want. This one. Try and observe if that is actually... the right way round, representationally, as we look at it, because if it is, that is going to make life rather easier. Either way, it needs to go a bit further. Okay, let's... am I even going the right way? Yes, yes I am. Okay, here we go. Looking at it. Yeah, I think actually maybe we're... I don't know. I didn't take another photo of it, did I? But now, which one did we actually use? Did we use the top one there or did we... No! No, that's the wrong way. Okay, I must have used the bottom one. Okay, so the top one anti-clockwise, and the bottom one is clockwise, which is kind of counterintuitive, actually. Okay, so once more around in that direction, if you please. And I think that's where we started, isn't it? Isn't that where we started? That's not very helpful, if so. But I'm not absolutely sure. Okay, well, the entrance is in a different place now, relative to... Let's just go on up. Yeah, all the way, all the way. Okay, does that look... Yes, that is what we meant. That is what we meant, I think. Now, we're going to have to change one of the others as well. We're probably going to have to change every single one of these. Whether they'll work as is or whether we have to... I've no idea. Let's have a look. Let's have a look. Which way did we turn this? We turned it... Did we turn it this way? Yeah, we did. Okay, so we'll work on this one. Is that going to be possible to turn so that it joins these two? It should be, shouldn't it? Yeah, it should be possible to get that to join those two. So yeah, let's give that a go. So we head back down to the teleporter again. All the way to the bottom. Okay. Ah, nuts. I forgot to take a picture of that. I think it's probably going to be a good idea to take a picture of that. I will get the room of this. But I think it's probably going to be a good idea to take a picture of that. So we can see where we're at. Okay, here we go. There we go. Right. Then we know what we're dealing with. Okay. We're going to be doing a lot of to-ing and fro-ing, but since when was that any different? Okay then. I don't think it matters what elevation we turn these around, we're still always going to be able to get in because they have doors all the way around them, which means we're always going to be able to access them. So that's, oops, that's good. That is good to know at least. Okay, so from where we are, it looks like that. Let's just see what our picture looks like. This is what we look like right now. We have this one here. Nope, this one here. And we need to turn it around to look like that, which I think is going to be, if we turn it twice clockwise, maybe. And I don't know that we're looking at that. No, it's not exactly. Okay, clockwise is the bottom one, isn't it? Okay, here we go. Clockwise. Now, that seems to have gone around quite a long way, actually. So maybe that, I don't know, does it turn it 90 degrees or does it, I don't know. Let's try turning it one more time and see what that's going to look like. And then all we can do is head back and see if that really has turned it the right way around. Quite possibly not. It's tricksy. Okay, I think this one's not going to fit no matter what, because no matter where I turn it, it doesn't actually join them up. So I'm not sure about that one. Maybe we have to, I don't know, it looks like it ought to work to me. It looks like it ought to work, but we don't seem to be able to turn it to the right orientation. I've tried several times now, and it doesn't seem to want to go, so I'm not sure about that. Also, the one that's over there, that does look like it should work, actually. So I think we'll just, for the moment, we'll just turn this around and see if we can get that bend to work. Because it looks like it ought to go in this direction and join up with a pathway that's directly below us now. So that means that we want that. We want to turn that clockwise. And I still haven't quite worked out. Do they only go round sort of, do they go around 180 degrees or something, which would explain why that one doesn't work. There may be something else we have to do for that. And I'm fairly sure that the one over there, no matter how we turn that, I don't know. That one looks like it ought to work as well, but I'm not sure if it will. Anyway, we'll deal with the one that's in front of us for the moment, and we'll see if we can get that to work as is. This way, okay. It's a little disorienting. Never quite know which way you're facing. Okay, so if I look, that's bending off to the right, and if I look at my photos, that's the most recent one, and that's bending off to the right, which means we are standing over there, in point of fact, looking at it. We need to get that actually going, I think, anti-clockwise, at which point it should sort of, yeah, face off to, well, it should kind of go in that orientation. Is that going to work? No, we basically need a, do we need a straight piece there? And we don't have a straight piece? Because no way are we going to be able to join that with that. Obviously, it's never going to work. Therefore, there must be something else we could do here. Now, we did open up some pathways here. This one over there, I can't remember which one goes where. Okay, this one leads to Hunras. I can tell that immediately because of the massively long hanging load time, which I just edited out, so you guys weren't as bored as I was. Therefore, we need to go this way, which leads to the bridge, I think. One of the bridges that we put in place in the previous episode. This one here. And we have teleportation devices on the other side. Now, where do these end up? I'm not sure. I don't remember. And then, of course, is there a teleportation? No, all the way over there. I'm not sure. Okay, so we maybe need to teleport something else, another section of maze in from somewhere. This is just a guess based on how teleportation has worked in previous, in previous episodes. Oh. Okay, that's interesting. So that kind of did do roughly what I thought. It's kind of changed the I don't know why or how, but it has changed the shape of that piece of the maze. I'm not sure if it's facing in the right direction or anything. It may well not be, but it's kind of difficult to tell at this point. It doesn't look like it's going to join anything up, but I don't honestly have a clue. As I say, this is very much kind of a trial and error thing. So, yeah, maybe I'll just go see if it's going to be possible to turn that around so that it's a bit more useful, but as I say, bit of a stab in the dark, really. Yep. Nothing ventured. Here we are again, getting quite good at following this little pathway up here. Okay, so, I don't have a clue what I'm doing. Maybe if we... Okay, that's turned it all the way around, pretty much. I'm sure that turns it kind of 180 degrees, so it's not going to make any difference, is it, surely? Yeah, because it's only got 2 points of orientation anyway, so for the moment, I'm just going to leave it. I have no idea anyway which way the thing's supposed to be facing. No way of telling at this juncture, so... Because it doesn't join up with anything at this point. I'm hoping at some point it will, but the fact that it's changed leads me to believe it's supposed to do that, so... Okay, we go back to the viewing platform now to see what it is we're looking at. And I should probably take another photo. For the records. And for reference. I'm surprised it hasn't got dark while I've been doing this. I'm surprised I haven't got old while I've... Oh, look! That actually does go straight through now. So that's looking vaguely like it might actually join stuff up. This section here is not doing anything, but I guess that's okay. That actually, yeah, makes some sense. We need, I think, to change the one that's directly opposite us to try and get that to join that up there. And I'm not sure if that will or not. We're going to have to turn this around, aren't we? Let's just do that. Because these two now join something up. This one does not, and that one over there does not. So I'm going to go to this one here. I don't think we've tried this one at all. And it looks to me like we should just be able to turn that kind of once to get that sort of facing the other way. So we're going to give that a go. So it's beginning to look like possibly we might be able to do this. Hopefully before I die of old age. There we go. Oh, I forgot to take a picture of it. Hey ho, I'm just going to give it one turn and that should do the trick, I reckon. Okay, that is actually what I meant, I think. I'm pretty sure that's what I meant to do. Excellent, so I just gave it another turn. Oh, blast. Got the wrong way there. It doesn't matter over much which way I go. I've still got just as far to go to get to the final one. Yo. And if we can turn this around so that it joins these two up, which looks like it ought to be possible. Looks like, but I'm not absolutely sure. So we'll have to see, really. So, yeah, basically, if we can get those two to join up, and it looks like we should be able to do it by turning it a couple of times clockwise. So, we'll give that a go. And if that doesn't work, we might have to see if we can change the shape of it the way I did last time, which basically meant a little bit of teleportation dancing. Still not sure how that works, but there you go. Okay, well, I admit defeat on this one. It looks like it should work, but it doesn't. Basically, the rotation is all wrong, which means that I've tried it every which way, every rotation, and unfortunately, it just never meets up. So I've come to the conclusion that the only thing I could do with that one is some sort of bizarre teleportation dance in hopes that it will change its form, basically, like the other one did. So that is what we're going to do. Basically what I did last time was this. We teleport to Hunrath. And then instead of turning it around or anything like that, we go this way. And we take one of the other teleporters that's across the bridge to get back to Mare. And then we go and see if it looks the same or if it's changed to a different shape. I have no idea why that would happen, but that did happen last time. And if it happens this time, it will just save my life and my sanity. Okay, so now we have to go this way, across this bridge, through the tunnel that we created in the last episode, and back to the maze. With our fingers crossed, because I really don't want to have to do this whole maze again, based on the fact that I've made an assumption that I was creating a pathway when in point of fact I wasn't. So, I'm kind of hoping that this is going to work, because I don't, as I say, want to have to start all over again. Okay, that... Does that look the same as it did before? I'm not sure. I'm going to see if I can... It looks like it's got the same kind of elbow to me, but I don't know whether... I don't know. I'm going to have to just see if it's possible. It looks like it ought to be possible to turn that around, and I am going to try and see if it is. That's the only thing I think to do, really, at this point, other than start all over again, and I really don't want to be doing that. Yes! Finally! Oh my god, we have a contiguous path. Right, so, now that we've finally got a pathway that goes through, where is it taking us to? Well, there's a villein device over there, but obviously we have to be able to access this pathway for a start off, so we're going to need one of these entrances here. Now, yeah, that goes that way, but that is a big lump of stone, so that's not going to help us at this point. I don't think that's a portal, but it may be, I guess. And then if we turn it once more, then we get in this end and get out that end. Is that going to work? I don't know, but I'm certainly going to try. I'm just glad I don't have to do that all over again. At least I hope not. I hope that this pathway is now actually going to where we need it to go. Yeah, I've gone down too far, haven't I? Yeah. So used to it. Now we have to do the rat run through the maze. There we go. I Thought I was never going to get this done. It was driving me up the wall. There we go. Knew what I had to do, but quite difficult to judge, actually. Ah, here we go. So, this pathway leads where exactly? Is that a gateway up there? Or I have no idea. We'll probably learn later on. And I assume we haven't been here before. Wherever the heck here is. So, we've got a way that we can get down here to something. And then up here goes to... where exactly? I don't know, just structure. And we've been over there already, so we can see where we've been and where we've come around to. So I guess we'll find out in the next episode where this has taken us. It looked like there was a screen down there, which means we may be able to make contact with Mayor Joseph again and find out where he is. Well, probably not find out where he is, to be honest, but we'll see where the path takes us from here on in. I'm not absolutely sure we've come to where we need to be, but one way or other, at least I think we've got the maze sorted out. It took ages, but we got there in the end. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. If you have, remember to hit that like button, and also feel free to leave me your comments and suggestions and sort of hints and tips, if there even are any, for this game. Mostly it's guesswork, I find. And I do hope you'll join me for the next episode of Obduction, or check out what else we have on the channel. Until the next video, keep gaming, keep surviving, and stay happy. Bye bye for now.